I'm Heather Sue Rosen, and I'm a medical sociologist. This is Medical Sociology 101, where I introduce you to basic concepts in medical sociology for free. In the last session, we discussed how medical sociology is different from other non-sociological health sciences. Today, we'll look at different approaches to research within medical sociology. When you crack open most medical sociology textbooks, they will start off by separating medical sociology into two categories: sociology in medicine and sociology of medicine. Sociology in medicine is research that's of interest to medical professionals, medical scientists, medical educators, medical practitioners, things that are important to medicine as an institution. Sociology of medicine tends to be research of interest to the general scientific field of sociology. Importantly, it's not that medicine is simply disinterested in sociology of medicine. The institution of medicine sometimes has a vested interest in silencing or arguing against sociology of medicine. Sociology of medicine may not be useful to medical professionals, but if, for example, sociology of medicine is critiquing medical practice, as is often the case, it might even move beyond useless to being perceived as offensive. To further explore the difference between sociology in versus of medicine, let's take the issue of compliance. From the medical perspective, patient compliance is vital for successful medical practice and treatment. If your patient is not listening to you, so for example, if they're not taking their medication and that medication is supposed to get them better, then you're going to have a much more difficult time treating that patient, and that means you're going to have a much harder time doing your job. Would have been much easier if the patient would have just complied with your treatment plan. Same thing with other things like surgery. Patient doesn't want to have surgery, and surgery is the way that you're able to do your job the best. Patient refuses, you can't do your job as well. So sociology in medicine would examine compliance with this medical perspective in mind. Sociology in medicine might investigate the barriers to patient compliance, but they might ask about these barriers in terms of patient behavior. So asking something like, why are these patients not compliant? With the goal of identifying things that can be addressed to help patients better comply so that medical professionals can have better chances of doing their jobs successfully. Now, moving to sociology of medicine. Greater field of sociology is interested in issues of power and inequality. So when examining compliance in terms of power and inequality, we might look at something like physician control over patients, which would not only contribute to medical sociology, but also to areas of sociology beyond medical sociology. One example is the larger sociological literature on deviance and social control. From this perspective, physicians offer something that patients can't obtain on their own, or at least not easily or safely. So prescription medications, surgery, imaging, these are all things that are considered both illegal and often dangerous when obtained from non-credentialed entities. This means patients must be compliant to avoid severe consequences like physical injury, disability, even death. Healthcare providers hold power then to help people feel better when they have few, if any, safe alternatives. Instead of looking at compliance as inherently positive or necessary, sociology of medicine can be used to critique the concept and the continued endorsement of compliance as positive or necessary by credentialed actors in medicine. So, sociology of medicine, similarly to sociology in medicine, may be interested in barriers to compliance, but because it doesn't assume that compliance is necessary or helpful to the patient, leaves some room to explore the patient experience. Sociology of medicine can explore things like mistrust of medical professionals, experiences with bias and discrimination in the clinical encounter, and the patient's understanding of a potential treatment as helpful versus their belief that that treatment is useless or harmful, independent of science on that treatment. So while sociology in medicine and sociology of medicine might both be interested in questions related to noncompliance, so this idea of why patients become noncompliant, sociology in medicine might approach that question with the intent of identifying something that will lead to increased compliance, where sociology of medicine might approach that question in terms of medical harm, so not taking the assumption that compliance is positive, and instead taking a more skeptical view that compliance might be an exercise of power on the part of the healthcare provider over the patient, and focusing on issues like the potential for patterns of exploitation and/or harm of certain groups of patients with shared characteristics. Sociology of Medicine might ask whether healthcare providers, because they're powerful, are inherently good or right. Sociology in Medicine would probably not ask this question at all, instead assuming the answer to just be yes. Now, interestingly, even though pretty much every medical sociology textbook available is going to emphasize this distinction between sociology in versus sociology of medicine, it's increasingly less common for medical sociology to fit neatly into either camp. Complicating things further is this push by medicine to be more socially conscious, to focus on things like bias and health disparities. I agree, it's great that this is happening, but there are implications, and one of those implications is this blurring of lines between what medicine considers important and what sociology or social science considers important, and a blurring of sociology in versus sociology of medicine. While medical sociology is becoming more interdisciplinary, most of the current work is still tailored to the field of sociology and structured as a contribution to sociological science and literature. The major subfields within medical sociology, then, are going to give us the best picture of today's approaches to medical sociology, one that's a little bit more accurate for today's medical sociology than the sociology in versus sociology of dichotomy. Medical sociologists, including those who study sociology in medicine and those who study sociology of medicine, research in a variety of areas, including disability, healthcare, diagnosis, alcohol and drug use, mental health, and health social movements, to name a few.